And as the lights go down in the Victoria Palace...
And so the Queen Mother and the Prince and Princess of Wales leave the Royal Box and make their way down onto the stage for what is the traditional climax for these evenings, when the Royal Party meets the people who've been entertaining them. Not just this evening, we hope, but like the rest of us throughout the year. And just presented is Norman Main. He's the producer of the show. Must be a very relieved man now it's all over. And a word or two with young Anthony Gatto, of course. He's only 11 now, as I was saying, but he started juggling when he was 5, and already he's appeared all over the place and won all sorts of awards. A lad with a bright future ahead of him. You might say the same sort of thing about Harvey and the Wallbangers, really. They made their debut only 3 years ago at the Edinburgh Festival. That's Prince Charles having a word there with Terry Wogan. Frank Thornton, heading the cast of Me and My Girl. He, of course, also had the task of ousting Dame Edna from the Royal Box at the beginning of the show. Emma Thompson, and on this side, Robert Lindsay. Princess of Wales. Pointing the finger at Rowan Atkinson. I have a feeling perhaps they share the same sense of humour. Now, the Comedy Tonight lineup, that's Paul Nicholas, with Billy Dainty and Jimmy Cricket on the far side, Bernie Winters and Leslie Crowther nearest to the camera. The Prince having a word with David Frost seems to be well recovered after that sinking feeling of going through the stage at the beginning of the show. Spike Milligan and Eric Sykes. They never did get that ever-growing plant delivered to the Royal Box, did they? The Queen Mother greeting the last of the Summer Wine trio, who are in the middle of making a new series of programmes at the moment. That is Harvey of the Wallbangers, Harvey Brough in the blue drape. Oh! Well, we wondered whether Barry Humphries would appear as Dame Edna at the end or as Les Patterson. I suppose he might also have appeared as Barry Humphries. Orville there getting a royal inspection with Keith Harris. Ronnie Corbett, Paul Daniels on the far side. Max Bygraves on this side. And just coming into the picture, you can see the two guests there, Henry Mancini and James Galway. And the Princess having a word with those two laughter makers, Dustin G and Les Dennis. And so as the Queen Mother reaches that popular pair, Jane Torvill and Christopher Dean, and old Clayton Farlow himself, Howard Keel, we come to the end of another memorable royal variety show. I'm sure we all hope the royal party enjoyed their evening. The stars giving the show, I know, did.